God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And thus be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you govern all things, both in heaven and on earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of your people, and in our time grant us your peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses summoned all Israel and said to them, "The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among your own people. You shall heed such a prophet. This is what you requested of the Lord your God at Horeb on the day of the assembly when you said, 'If I hear the voice of the Lord my God any more or ever again see this great fire, I will die.' Then the Lord replied to me, 'They are right in what they have said. I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their own people. I will put my words in the mouth of the prophet, who shall speak to them everything that I command. Anyone who does not heed the words that the prophet shall speak in my name, I myself will hold accountable. But any prophet who speaks in the name of other gods, or who presumes to speak in my name a word that I have not commanded the prophet to speak, that prophet shall die.'" The word of the Lord. Thanks.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Now, concerning food sacrificed to idols, we know that all of us possess knowledge. Knowledge puffs up, but love builds up. Anyone who claims to know something does not yet have necessary knowledge, but anyone who loves God is known by him. Hence, as to the eating of food offered to idols, we know that no idol in the world really exists, and that there is no God but one. Indeed, even though there may be so-called gods in heaven or on earth, as in fact there are many gods and many lords, yet for us there is one God, the Father, from whom are all things and for whom we exist, and one Lord, Jesus Christ, through whom are all things and through whom we exist. It is not everyone, however, who has this knowledge. Since some have become so accustomed to idols until now, they still think of the food they eat as food offered to an idol, and their conscience, being weak, is defiled. Food will not bring us close to God. We are no worse off if we do not eat, and no better off if we do. But take care that this liberty of yours does not somehow become a stumbling block to the weak. For if others see you, who possess knowledge, eating in the temple of an idol, might they not, since their conscience is weak, be encouraged to the point of eating food sacrificed to idols? So by your knowledge, those weak believers for whom Christ died are destroyed. But when you thus sin against members of your family and wound their conscience when it is weak, you sin against Christ. Therefore, if food is a cause for their failing, I will never eat meat, so that I may not cause one of them to fall. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
They were astounded at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. Just then there was in the synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." But Jesus rebuked him, saying, "Be silent and come out of him." And the unclean spirit, convulsing him and crying with a loud voice, came out of him. They were all amazed, and they kept on asking one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority. He commands even the unclean spirits, and they obey him." At once his fame began to spread throughout the surrounding region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before our family left for our cross-country trip this summer during sabbatical, I had been warned by a fellow parishioner. She told me, "I never really understood the word awesome until I saw the Grand Canyon." Now, the word awesome seemed so overwhelming at the time. Maybe that's because we use the word for things that are a little less than awesome. An awesome movie, an awesome meal, an awesome day. But as I stood at that rail, overlooking the massiveness of the Grand Canyon, my brain sort of just scrambled. It was as if my brain couldn't comprehend the sheer vastness of that view in front of me. How far does that canyon really stretch? How deep is that bottom from here? How long did it take those little specks that must be hikers to get there? Or maybe more deeply, how did God conceive of such an indescribably beautiful thing? As tears welled in my eyes at the Grand Canyon's inconceivability, I finally understood the word awesome. In today's gospel, this is the reaction of the crowd to Jesus. Jesus comes into the temple on the Sabbath, and he teaches like no other teacher has. The teachers they know always say things like, "As Moses said," or "As Rabbi so-and-so said." Jesus speaks with a quiet but compelling authority all of his own. And the people are astonished, awestruck, and amazed. Their amazement doesn't stop with Jesus's use of his unique authority and his teaching. They see his unique words carry with them the power to make the unclean clean. Like standing on the edge of the Grand Canyon, their minds are scrambled. They cannot understand this new thing. They are just beginning to taste what one scholar describes as one of the salient characteristics of the Gospel of Mark, the motif of surprise, wonder, awe, and fear, the reactions that embrace all those aspects of Jesus' ministry. Those gathered today watch Jesus and can clearly say, "He is awesome." This past year of ministry at Hickory Neck has struck me in a similar way. I have stepped back many a time over this last year and looked at this community with a sense of awe. I've told you repeatedly that one of our core values at Hickory Neck is our sense of curiosity, our willingness to try new things. I talk about that core value a lot because that core value is extremely uncommon in churches. Put more simply, our core value of experimentation and playfulness is awesome. I watched as your sabbatical team and your vestry this past year embraced the idea of mutual sabbatical with gusto, confidence, and playfulness. I watched as this parish didn't look at sabbatical as an obligation or a burden to bear, but as an opportunity to grow, to try on new things, to encounter God in fresh ways. I watched you learn and laugh and love. I watched you push yourselves and encourage one another. I watched you grow in your relationship with God and with one another. And the view was awesome. But I also watched you with the hard things this past year. I watched as you grieved, struggled in your faith, and said goodbye to dear friends, all while embracing and comforting one another. I watched as our stewardship team took on a hefty deficit budget and decided to try a new approach to stewardship that felt at times uncomfortable, unfamiliar, and hard, and yet ended the year with not only not incurring a deficit, but only using 8% of the savings that we had planned to use. I watched as your vestry held itself accountable to strategic goals that the vestry set for itself, and I watched the vestry struggle through hard questions about process and systems. And I saw the vestry grow into the fullness of their leadership. I watched a community struggle with decreased volunteerism and long-held preferences for the way we've always done things. And I watched our community step boldly into doing things differently. And I have to tell you, even and maybe especially in the hard stuff of ministry, the view has been awesome. We started 2023 as almost two communities. Those long-timers who have been a part of Hickory Neck for ages, but many of whom were away during long portions of the pandemic, and those newer members who made their way to Hickory Neck during and post-pandemic, who didn't have a clue about how things had always been, but they knew that they had found something special in this community. One of our hopes had been that those two communities within a community would use our time of sabbatical to find a new Hickory Neck, to build a new way of being involved in shared leadership, creative ministries, and fresh encounters with the sacred. I stand here today in wonder as I look at Hickory Neck a year later, and I have to tell you, the view is awesome. We head into 2024 with some revenue challenges, with some needs for increased participation and leadership, and with the tensions that always exist in a growing church. But we also head into 2024 with a renewed sense of wonder and awe in all that God is doing in our midst. From re-energized ministries to the wider community, hosting the homeless, as we'll be doing in a few weeks' time, building beds for children in our community who haven't had a bed, feeding the hungry, and clothing those who struggle, to fresh and creative ministries that we've never tried before, a children's music ministry that will launch this summer in the form of a chorister camp, to invitations to grow closer to that Jesus who is truly awesome, through liturgies and study and service. God has incredible things in store this year for us. And the view is awesome. Amen.
Holy God, you are gracious and full of compassion. Mercifully hear the supplications of your people. Holy God, you search us out and know us. Your servants are listening. We pray for all your holy church, Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Susan, our bishop, and Jennifer, Charles, Jim, and Bob, our clergy. Arise, shine, for the light has come. Holy God, you call the whole world to perceive your glory. We pray that through your grace, all nations and all in authority shall come to your light. We pray for the President Biden, Governor Youngkin, legislatures, and the judiciary, this community, the nation, and the world. Arise, shine, for the light has come. Holy God, you shall deliver the poor who cry out in distress. Grant us all the liberty of the abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, especially through the ministry of fish. Arise, shine, for the light has come.
And the glory of the Lord has risen on us.
Holy God, you alone are our rock and our salvation, our stronghold. We pray that your people in any need or trouble may shine with radiance of Christ's glory. Praying especially for Heather, Frank, Lisa, Mike, Jean, Craig, Cindy, Sue, Scott, George, Cheryl, Susie, Dale, Shirley, Grayson, Brandon, Esther, Curtis, Buddy, Ellen, Martine, Cindy, Don, April, and Julie. And to those being impacted by violence in the Holy Land. For the men and women serving in the armed forces, especially Zachary, Jenny, Tim, Max, Owen, and Billy, arise, shine, for the light has come.
And the glory of the Lord has risen upon us.
Holy God, you welcome with your divine pleasure all the faithful departed. Lead us, who know you by faith, to your presence, where we may see the glory face to face. Arise and shine, for the light has come. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father.
In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Good morning and welcome to Hickory Neck. We are so glad you are here this morning. I'm going to invite Skip to come on up. He's going to talk to us a little bit about winter shelter. While he's coming up, we had our annual meeting today, and we're so thankful for our four new vestry members who have agreed to serve. We are excited to be working with them. We also had our second annual Outstanding Service Award presented to Terry Linsenmeyer. So if you see her today, make sure to check out her cross and give her a congratulations and a thank you for her service. And then also, today is our collection day for fish. So if you brought those canned goods and box items, you can leave those here before you go. So Skip, tell us what's going on with Winter Shelter.
Well, good morning, everyone. I guess it's my turn to play a tag team to come up and request your assistance in staffing our Winter Shelter for the homeless. This year, we have been fortunate because we have partnered with two other churches, King of Glory and Liberty Live. They have agreed to take four of the seven nights at the shelter, so they will be providing all the staffing and all the meals and everything. So all we need is three nights. So that takes a big burden off us, but we still have plenty of slots. We're doing pretty well for our first Sunday night. We have a few slots left that we can sign up for, but we really have some vacancies on Friday and Saturday into Sunday morning, and then rebuilding the church for service at 10 o'clock, yes. So for those of you who have already signed up, thank you very much, we appreciate it. For those of you who haven't, we have the list of people who signed up on their time and talent forms post-winter shelter, or work winter shelter. So we'll probably be receiving a call if we don't get you to sign up on our list. Thank you.
Thank you. Do keep an eye on your epistle. There are all kinds of announcements in it, including about winter shelter, some stuff coming up for care packages for our college students, Shrove Tuesday, Ash Wednesday, it's already coming. So keep an eye on all of that and make sure you make a note of those dates. There are things that you can sign up for or people you can contact with questions. So please do that and keep an eye on that. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give them thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you've delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming. Praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray.
Thank you.
all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.